In this video, I'm painting a woman's silhouette, and it's an acrylic painting tutorial. So tonight I am painting a woman worshiping. I call it worship girl, and she's very whimsical. I like the bright colors of lilac and pink. So I'm gonna use a little spray bottle of water. I have a red, white, blue and brown, a yellow and gold acrylics. My brushes are always the same. I'm using an inch flat brush, a round brush. It's a number 2 round brush and a tiny brush. I'm starting with my white acrylic, mixing some water in it. The canvas I'm using is a 16 by 20. And I had a painting initially that I wasn't gonna use because I have plenty of duplicates of some of my paintings because I give classes. So I just put a little bit of gesso on it, and this is gonna give me a nice background, a nice textured background. So I like doing that. I like painting several layers on a canvas. I'm starting with a lilac sky. That I'm gonna just apply from side to side. I'm not too worried about the strokes. I'm just covering the first two-thirds of my canvas with a light lilac color. So I just mix a little bit of white, a tiny bit of red and blue. I'm gonna add a little bit more red to darken my color a little bit. And whenever you wanna do a transition from one color to another, the trick is to kind of go back upward as you apply your darker color. Just go back up with strokes that will just go side to side and just loosely go back onto the darker color, and back and forth from the darker to the lighter color, and just, you know, go back over the darker stroke of color that you just applied, and then you're gonna pick up a little bit of that darker color and bring it back up. So you're going back and forth. And this is really, you don't want to be rushed. You want to add water so that your acrylics doesn't dry, so that it gives you the opportunity to play with your transition. So now I'm going back into the darker shade and just bring it down a little bit more. And I go back up and down. So again, the transition is all about blending back and forth. I added a little bit of yellow. Now I have kind of a peach color that I put underneath the pink. And my cat is visiting. Hello, Hope. Her tail is almost brushing my canvas. She wants to paint with her tail. So yeah, I like the warmer peach next to that almost like fuchsia color. And then the sky is a nice light lilac. I'm adding a little bit of white just to again help with that transition. When I say play with your brush strokes, I really mean it. Just have fun with going back and forth from top to bottom, but you don't want to go straight from your light color and quickly go to your dark color. You really want to transition with some middle tones and just play with your colors and see what it gives you. Right now I want to go to the bottom of my canvas with a darker purple, but I don't want to go straight from this peach color to a dark purple. I'm going to kind of do a color in between. So this is what I'm doing right now. I'm playing with those brush strokes and with the transitions, kind of going back up to that lilac. I was kind of creating a frame almost. Now I picked up a little bit more of that purple, kind of to smooth out the transition between the peach going towards a darker purple. So now I'm adding yellow, and this is gonna, I'm kind of making my color a little bit more neutral. So it's not darken, it's, I'm not darkening my color too much yet, but by adding like white and a little bit of yellow, I thought it would be a little darker. So now I'm gonna go ahead and add a tiny bit of brown in there. So I'm going very neutral right now. And I do want to go purple, but before I go purple, I'm playing with this kind of neutral beige slash peach color. And you know, color is something natural for me. I'm kind of mixing this color as I go. So if you're following me, feel free to pause the video and kind of blend your colors. Take your time to blend that neutral and go to that purple, because it's something that you need to kind of go in steps. So now I'm just blending everything and kind of hoping for the best, but I know it's gonna work out, because again, colors is something that comes naturally to me. So I'm hoping you're following me and just pausing the video. I needed to add a little splash of color in that neutral. So now I'm coming back with some red, and I really like what this is giving me. It's not going from, you know, like the like pink to a dark purple, and that's what I wanted. Now I continue to want to blend and make that transition. So I just do not rinse your brush. Just add a little bit of water, a touch of white, and I just kind of go with my brush over the color with some white, and now with some red. So this is what transitioning with the colors is all about. I'm putting some brush strokes of the brighter pink and or brighter red, and now I'm blending. So again, I'm going upward with some of that color, and it's helping developing this beautiful transition. Smooth those lines a little bit more, but I'm really liking what this is giving me. It's almost like it's almost a sunset, but I didn't really want to go for a sunset. It's just a color transition from like this really pretty violet to a nice neutral kind of rich brown, red brown. Now I am adding some of that violet into the darker color. Again, what does that do? It's smoothing out the transition. And I like the way this looks. Now I'm gonna spray some water, because I want to create some drips and some water effect in my background. Now I'm gonna play with my fingers and just kind of do some organic shapes, just little dots with my ring fingers, with my fingers on my canvas. A little bit of white, little dots. Again, we're doing a silhouette, a woman's silhouette, and I really want to do a cool background and do that dark silhouette as an overlay, and then we're gonna work that silhouette and add a lot of texture and a lot of dimension to it. So, but now we're still working on the background. I just put quite a few drops of water on my brush and soaked it in water, and just grabbed a little bit of the lightest color of my background, which is that violet color. And I'm just gently tapping on another paintbrush to create some little splatters of paint. I like the whimsical look of this background. So now I'm gonna draw with a paint pen. I'm going straight onto the canvas, but I'm providing you with a stencil. Now, in the description below, I give you a link for you to print the stencil. And when you want to transfer your silhouette onto your canvas, make sure it's nice and dry. And you use a sheet of carbon paper. Again, the link to everything you're going to need to transfer the image is in the description. So you would just use a little bit of tape, you know, tape your photocopy onto your background. Again, make sure it's dry, because otherwise you're going to end up with some dark areas because of the carbon paper. So yeah, you just put the carbon paper between the photocopy and your background, your painted background, and you just trace all the lines. And before you remove it, make sure that you peek underneath to make sure all your lines are transferred. And make sure you press hard enough so that, you know, you can see your outline nice and dark. Now I'm using a paint pen. You can definitely use a paint pen to go over your, you know, your lines and then paint inside. This is a black paint pen, but I'm going to paint my silhouette with kind of a very dark blue, kind of eggplant color. I'm gonna add some brown, blue, and red to paint my silhouette. Again, I'm doing all this freehand, so if my arms are a little bit, the proportions are a little bit off, it's okay. I'm just having fun. I'm not looking for perfection. I just want this woman to worship and be, you know, just very spontaneous and whimsical. And I'm gonna use a different, a small brush for some of the details. Right now I'm loosely outlining her body. And I'm mixing blue, brown, red. And I'm gonna use the small brush to paint within my guidelines. I decided to make her hair longer and flowy, so I'm just drawing with my paint pen again and coming back with my paint. I'm using thick coats of acrylics right now and keeping my silhouette nice and whimsical, and I like using texture in the silhouette. So I'm doing swirls, and I'm using the back of my brush to do some carving in there. So it's all about texture and just painting with emotion and having fun. I did a few little petals with the dark color and dark paint, but I'm gonna actually add a little bit more in a little bit. Right now I'm just finishing to outline and define the hand. I'm placing my hand over this little area. I just wanted to see if I liked it better painted, and sure enough, I just went over it with the paint because I'm gonna use white to define more of the silhouette, and I just kind of wanted to start from a darker background. Now I can just kind of play with my white paint and do some highlights and some lighter white areas into the entire silhouette, mostly in her hair and contouring as well. You know what's great about painting a silhouette is if you put too much white or there's something you don't like, it's really easy to go over and fix it. Right now I'm doing a cool kind of swirly bracelet. And I'm gonna have her hold again more swirls. I'm making this just as I go. I like to doodle when I paint. I like to doodle with a pencil, with pastels. You know, whenever you get a chance to have a piece of paper and a pen, try it. Just do some swirls and doodle. Even if it's not looking like anything, doodling is a form of art and it's a lot of fun and you have no expectation. And it's truly a form of self-expression. The other day during church, I brought my smaller little journal and the pastor said something that truly stayed with me, and I wrote into my journal, and I actually want to share this. He said, reorient your entire life around God and His people. I wrote it in my journal, and I keep waking up with this in my mind. It's just really sinking into my subconscious, and I truly want to use my gift, my God-given talent to, you know, and make those videos to, you know, chat about God and about Jesus and about how it is just so freeing to know that you are forgiven, that you can lift and rise from the ashes and go towards the light and know that you're just so loved. And this is what this painting is all about. It's going from the dark side on the left, those little pieces of ashes flying around and escaping. She is literally escaping that dark past and raising her hands towards God. Oop, I made that thumb a little bit smaller. It was a little too big. See how easy it is? You can't mess this up. When you do a silhouette, it's just so fun to, add white and play with it, and you know that if you don't like it, you're just gonna go over with some dark, you know, add the dark color again. It's just play with your paints and play with that silhouette. Right now I'm adding more of those dark petals or ashes flying around. So you do that with a small brush and you just very spontaneous little brush strokes. So right now, this is what I was talking about. I think that there's a little bit too much white details in my hair, so I am going to go back over some of those white highlights and make it a little bit darker. I just think I lost a little bit of the silhouette of the transition. It's a little bit too busy. So this is a perfect example of having as much fun as you want with your white, and then okay, time to add a little bit of that darker color. Here we go. So the flowers that I added and that the little pearls in her hair, just with your small brush, to do the flowers, you press down. You just add paint and you press your paintbrush down. So one, like a star, two, three, turn your wrist, four, five. Practice before you do it on canvas. You can practice on a piece of paper. And again, look, they don't have to be perfect. You just play with the paint. I love how she's abandoning herself. Earlier I said she was escaping, but I think it's more of an abandon and a sense of security, and just she just looks really free and light. She is surrendering. So when you paint, I invite you to follow my steps and everything. But if you can put some Christian music, some music, whatever you prefer, and paint with music, it is just so much fun. I really like that I added those flowers because it really balances from a lot of flow and swirls and texture to crisp little white flowers. I like the contrast that it gives me. I'm using my fingers to add gold in the right, on the top right corner. So it represents more light. Represents the richness of God. And the yellow is just blessings. Because he showers you with blessings. Small, big. Feel free to add more or a little bit less, or just stick to white. You don't have to add the yellow. You can change any colors, anything about that painting. Again, I'm gonna give you the link for you to print your stencil. And if you want to try to draw, hey, go ahead and have fun. Your silhouette can be whatever you want it to be. I really hope you enjoyed the woman silhouette acrylic painting tutorial today. And as I'm finishing my painting, please subscribe to my channel. Hit that subscribe button and don't forget to hit the little bell next to it so that you get my notification when I upload a new video. And give me a like. If you enjoyed this video, just hit that like button. It really helps me with YouTube, and my channel is very new, so I'm just growing it very organically, but it's growing, and I'm just so thankful for you to be watching my videos. I really mean this. I hope you enjoyed doing this painting with me. She's pretty. I really like how she turned out. Worshipping girl with her wavy arms. Hey, if you want to see more videos, click on the links on this screen right now. Connect with me on Twitter and Instagram at PaintWithNat. And please give me a like if you enjoyed this video. Until my next video, stay creative. Bye.